Hi everyone, welcome back to the class. And today we're going to discuss about plan, guys. Okay, let me have a notepad. Plan, guys, with layer properties, means not layer properties but layers panel. Okay, we're going to discuss about layer panel, and we're going to discuss about plan also. Okay, before going to plan, what we need is some basic concepts, guys, some basic requirements. And what are the basic requirements is about doors, windows, ventilation, guys. Okay, and after some minimum room requirements like hall or drawing room, bedroom or living room, and kitchen, toilets or bathrooms. Okay, like there was some basic requirements which you should give to a building plan, in building plan. Okay, let's consider those all things. Okay, and now firstly we're gonna consider about basic plans, guys. Okay, first of all, basic plans, I'm gonna type here. Okay, just note it down. Okay, here we're gonna start. Okay, with plan. And the first one we're gonna do is door scheduling. Okay, door schedule. In this door schedule, we have different types of doors, guys. Let me show you which plan I'm going. Okay, this is the plan I'm drawing, guys. You can see here. Like this, you have D1 means main door, and D2 means this door, guys. And we have D1, D2, and this is a D3, guys. Okay, and there are many things, and you can see here window one, window 2, window 3, like that. There were so many things. Okay, like this, there are basic requirements, and here the ventilation, guys. Okay, and you can see the bedroom dimension and the master bedroom dimension, dining, kitchen, drawing room is hall. Okay, these were the basic requirements, guys, what you should provide in your plan. That basic requirement I'm going to tell you now. Okay, only basic. If you go to advanced, I'm going to tell you in the next class itself. Okay, at present I'm going to draw two bedroom flat, guys. Okay, let's go to our plan, guys. Before going to plan, I'm gonna write down some of the detailing notes, guys. Just take it down. Okay, first one is D1, guys. Okay, D1. For D1, you have 1.2 meter into 1.2 meter, guys. And if you want any thickness, guys, thickness is common for everything. Okay, I'm gonna set it up. Okay, thickness is 0.05, okay, meters. Okay, I'm gonna I'm just considering units also. Okay, so that you should not confuse. Okay, and after that, this is D1 means somewhat main door, like that. Okay, D2, and in this case of D2, I'm going to consider 0.9 meter into 1.95. But in basic concepts, what I consider is wrong here. Okay, this is 2.2. okay, this is the height, guys. Let me have again somewhat detail, not like this. Okay, let me have like this. This is length, this is height. Okay, and this is thickness, guys. There's no need of length and breadth like that. Okay, and after that we have this is somewhat bedroom door, like this, guys, D2. And after that we had 0.85 meter into 1.85 meter, guys. In some cases we consider 2.2 as a main height, guys, and after that we want to consider all these things we're going to include all these things as 2.2 only in some cases, okay? Okay, let's this is door scheduling, guys. And when coming to window scheduling, okay, this class is gonna take some time, guys. And the thickness of window scheduling is not 0.05. Don't consider that much thickness, okay? Okay. Like this, we had L, capital L, and H, okay? And now there is a W1, okay? W1 for 1.5 meter, guys, in length, and with height, and in case of height, we're gonna have 1.2 meter, and this one divided by 2, 1.2 meter into 1.2 meter, and this is window scheduling, guys, okay? Window scheduling. And now I'm going to consider another thing as ventilation, okay? Okay, for ventilation, what you're gonna have is V, guys, only V. If you want V2, you can only gonna consider also. In this ventilation, the normal requirement is 0.5 meter, means length, to 0.4 meter, okay? Like this, okay? Okay, like this, guys. And that's it, guys. This is a scheduling of doors and windows and ventilation. And now let's go to plan, guys, plan view. In case of a plan view, guys, let me take some of the minimum requirements, okay? Okay, let's minimum. Requirements, okay, for rooms, okay, means minimum requirements, guys. This should be the minimum only, okay? After that, you can customize according to your plan, okay? I'm gonna tell you how to customize this one, okay? And first one is hall, and we can call it as drawing room, guys. And it's gonna be like this, guys. Let me tell you how it's gonna be, okay? In this one, you can also notice one thing, like the hall first, the length and width, okay? 3 meter into 3 meter. Okay, this is a minimum width and length and width, guys. Okay, let me tell you tap. You're gonna have length into width, okay? This length into width, LB, okay? I'm gonna tell you how. And the next one is bedroom, guys, okay? These were the dimensions in meters, guys. In India we won't use meters often, but when I'm teaching you in this way, the meters is very much simple, guys, to learn, okay? These were the minimum requirements, guys, okay? Not the absolute requirements, okay? Okay, let's have like this, okay? So that you can easily understand. Okay? And the third one is kitchen, guys. okay, kitchen. In case of kitchen, normally have like 0.2 meter by 2 meter, okay. And after that, we had toilets, guys, like our bathrooms. Okay, or we can also call it as toilets. We don't often call it as toilets. Washroom also we can call it, okay. And in this, we're gonna have 1.4 meter into 1.4 meter, okay. And after that, we had a and I think so that's it, guys, for this. And I did this one also. Staircase, okay. Staircase width should be like 2 meter, okay, 2 meter width, guys, okay. I'm gonna tell you how it is. This is about meters, guys. I'm gonna tell you in inches also in next diagram, okay. In that I will explain you how you can set our things in meters also, okay. Okay, that's it, guys. Let me tell you a small formula, guys, okay. I think so. I hope everyone wrote it down, okay. Wrote all these things, guys, okay. Everyone must write this one and then we can start our class, okay. And after that, there is a minimum requirement for window, guys. This is some of our basic formula, guys. This is just a formula, but like technique also, we can call it as technique also. Minimum window requirements like that, okay. In case of residential area, guys. Area. Gonna have 8%, okay. 8% in floor area, okay. In second case, this is residential purpose, means our home, okay. We call simply call it as home. In case of commercial area is simply I can tell you like cinema halls and theaters like that, okay. The theaters and shopping malls like that. But I can also tell to you in simple way is your classroom. Go to your classroom and check, just go to your classroom and count how many windows are there. Let me tell you this one and then I'm going to come to you, okay. Commercial area. In case of commercial area, you're gonna have like 20%, okay. In floor area, okay, like this. And next thing is about walls, guys, okay. About walls, okay. In case of interior wall, the thickness is the thickness, guys, this is thickness is 0.15 meters or we can call it as 6 inch, okay. In case of exterior wall, guys, exterior wall, we had 0.25 in the case of exterior wall. This is about 10 feet. And that's it, guys. This is all about. I just want to write it down, okay. I hope everyone wrote it down, everything. I'm gonna just pause the video, guys. If anyone haven't written this information in your notebook, just note it down, okay. And then we're going to start the class. Let's have like this, okay. Like this. This is going to be heading like that, okay. minimum door requirements, and like this, and not that much. Okay. And then this is ventilation, and this one also door scheduling. Okay, we can call it as scheduling. It's your wish, guys. Okay, sorry if there is a misspelling mistakes. Okay, that's it, guys. I hope everyone note down the class. And now I'm gonna go to the AutoCAD, guys. Go to AutoCAD and click on start drawings. Okay, after clicking on start drawings, guys, if anyone new to this one, guys, I'm gonna ping in description, guys, about the AutoCAD playlist. Okay, I think so this is episode 13 or in AutoCAD series this is 13, guys, 13 or 14, I don't know, but I have done AutoCAD classes previously, guys. I just have done AutoCAD classes, guys, in YouTube, in my playlist. Okay, you can go and check it out, how you can use all these tools, guys, like drawing tools, modify tools, annotation, layers, and everything. Okay, I'm gonna divide this one in two parts, guys. Okay, first part is almost 25 minutes. Okay, and this another part also will come, guys. Okay, let's start the process. First of all, let me remove this this one, guys. Okay, and after that you're gonna have, look at this. Okay, like this you're gonna have. And let me draw some diagrams, guys, like bedroom, bathroom, and door, window, like that. When you go to site, guys, there should be a what you observe is nothing, but what you need to do is you need to construct those things. Okay, like that, I'm telling you. Okay, just note it down. Okay, I'm going to tell you. Let me take first of all, what you need to do is after coming to here, you need to set units UN, enter. And in case of UN, what you need to have is first one is decimal. Why? Because we are doing in meters. And precision should be 0.00 and 00, four zeros. And angle means, type means decimal degrees. And precision should be 0.00, guys. That is enough, okay, for angle. In case of insertion scale, guys, you can have like meters, okay. And after that, set it at default and direction as east, guys, okay. You must consider this one as east. Don't forget, okay. And after that, click on OK. And after clicking on OK, what you need to set is limits, guys. Okay, the limits command is LIMITS, guys. Just type it fully. Okay, click on enter. And after typing fully, you can notice here limits lower left corner. You can have 0, 0. Okay, 0, 0. Type enter 0, 0, guys. If you don't know how to set limits, guys, I'm gonna ping you in description so that you can watch the video in this playlist, guys. You can see how to set limits in that video. You can in that video you can see, guys, in this playlist how to set video, guys. I think so that is 3rd one or 4th one, I don't know, but just check it out. Okay, and after that you can see limit specify upper coming order. I'm going to set it as minimum as 100, 100. Okay, click on enter. And after clicking on enter, just check it out about this one, guys, status bar. In this status bar you had on grid, okay, your wish. And if you want to add dynamic mode or off it, your wish, guys. Okay, and you must on this one, polar tracking, guys. Just click on this, and in this polar tracking make sure that you must only set in 90, 180, 270, 360, only that one only. Just click on that. Okay, okay, just check it out. And after that, off it, guys. Okay, or if you want to on it, use your wish. Okay, and after that, just go to here. Okay, just on it, guys. This is called object snapping. If you are not oning this object snapping, you are out of this class, guys. Why? Because this is master shoot. In this object snapping, you must select endpoint, guys. Next one is midpoint. Make sure that you must set it midpoint. Center is evolve based, guys. You must set, you can have it center. This is for circle for center, okay. And after that is insertion scale, okay. Insert intersection. And next one is extension, guys. You must stop it intersection. And next one is perpendicular. As of now, I'm just unticking nearest, guys. I'm going to tell you when you wanna click the nearest, okay. And after that, what you're gonna have is rectangle, okay. Just type REC rectangle command, and what it is saying, specify first corner point, means I'm gonna click on here. Clicking on here, what you notice is somewhat hundreds, guys, 500, 600, like that. I'm gonna zoom it, okay, like this. This is enough, guys. And in this, what I'm typing is first one is master bedroom, guys, okay. First one is master bedroom. Let me simply draw this one, and let me tell you how to draw. Okay, first one is master bedroom. First one is 3.5 meters, comma 3 meters. Okay, enter. Just zoom it. This is master bedroom, and just enter rectangle, guys, and click on enter. Okay, and in this. Just have a space, okay. And in this, I'm gonna have like bathroom, guys, here, okay. In this case of bathroom, we're gonna have 1.4 meters. Let me tell you where I'm taking all these things. 1.4 meters. Just check it out, guys. What I told is a minimum requirements for rooms. Length into depth. In this case, what you are seeing is hall, means hall, if you have 3 meter by 3 meter, minimum bedroom, guys, 3 meter into 3 meter, and kitchen should be 2 meter into 2 meter, and bathroom, washing room is 1.4 meter into 1.4 meter, and staircase width is 2 meters, guys. This is simple process, guys, okay. And click on M, just move it, guys. Just move it. I don't know why it is hanging out, guys. I don't know. Okay, now let's do the work. And next one is rectangle. Not next one, guys. Everything is rectangle. Okay, this is master bedroom, and this is a bathroom, guys. And next one is a bedroom. Okay. How much I'm taking is 3 meter comma 3 meter, okay, and click on enter. And next one is bathroom, guys, okay. I'm just telling you 2 bedroom flat now, that's why I'm telling this one, okay. 1.4 comma 1.4, enter, just move it downwards. Okay, like this. And at here, we can see here, rectangle, I'm going to take another one. And this one is going to be like, I'm going to tell you how to take. This is called dining, guys. Okay, in case of dining, you can notice here, 3.5 meters. I'm taking 3.5 meters. Why? Because, why? Okay, before drawing this one, let me have something, guys, like a dimension. In case of dimension, click on dimension. This one is huge. Let me cancel this one. Go to annotation, and what I told is go to here. Okay, after clicking on this one, just click on this and have a new one, guys, new dimension. Okay, after having new dimension, what you're gonna have is dim, just type dim, guys, okay, as your new dimension and start with standard only, okay, and continue. Okay, in this one what you're gonna have is if you want to set as arrow size 0.18 as default, and this here is a text size as 0.18, make sure here in symbols and arrows go to arrow size 0.18, okay. In text, go to text size as 0.18, okay, and close it, and go to here guys and click on this, okay, and click on dimension, start point, end point. This is somewhat not that much big. And after this, go to this one guys, change it to 0.36, okay, just doubling it. And this one has 0.36, okay, and click on OK, and close it. We can see here, this is somewhat visible to you, okay. And go to dimension, the dimension is, and click on here, this is 3 meters, okay. And this one guys, 0.14, okay. Okay guys, just take this dimension, okay, and I'm going to name it also here after drawing all these things, okay. And now what you're gonna have is a rectangle, okay, again rectangle. And in this what you're gonna have is a dining room guys, okay. In case of dining room, what you have is what you must set, the length of bedroom must be equal to the dining room. For that what you need to do is 3.5 meters, just 3.5 meters. And no, just cancel it, rectangle. This is dining room guys, okay, 3.5 meters comma 2.5 meters, and click on enter, okay. Let me move it, okay, and have dimensions guys. And now let's have kitchen and rectangle, enter, 3.5 comma 2, enter, okay, and dimension guys, one 3.5, click on enter, okay. And in case of hall, we must adjust guys, we should not draw directly, we must adjust the hall, okay, okay. And now what you need to do is very simple. Okay, these were the dimensions guys, everyone just note it down, okay, single line, let's have here, this is a master bedroom like that, I'm taking as M, okay, master M bedroom, okay. In this M bedroom, how much I had is 3.5 meter into 3, okay, just rotate, okay, no, don't do it guys, I'm just drawing it as sample. Just look at this one, how I am drawing, okay? Okay, that's it guys. In case of bathroom, this is bathroom. Okay, just note it down guys. That's why I'm just typing here like this, okay. Okay. Everyone write it down, pause the video and write it down, everyone write it down guys, this one, okay. What happened to this? Okay, everyone write it down, this one, okay, just write it down. And after that, I'm gonna start the class, guys. Okay, pause the video and write it down. Okay, everyone, I think so. Everyone wrote this one, and after that, I'm gonna start the class. Okay. Okay, and just compare this one, guys. There is a bedroom. This is master bedroom, guys. Master bedroom always should be have some age over bedroom, children's bedroom, guys. We just consider it as bedroom, okay. And we have the bedroom as minimum dimension 3 meter into 3 meter, and you can see here in bedroom 3 meter into 3 meter. When coming to master bedroom, we must have some more somewhat in dimension view. We must have somewhat length above it, okay, length or width above it, okay. In case of master bedroom, what we have is 3.5 meters into 3, okay. And next one is kitchen, guys. This is kitchen, and kitchen is 3.5 meter into 2 meter, okay. And after that, this is dining, okay. In dining, we have 3.5 into 2.5, okay. And this is what bathrooms, guys, 1.4 into 1.4. And after this also bathroom, 1.4 into 1.4, okay. And that's it, guys. For today's class. From tomorrow, I'm gonna start drawing, guys. Drawing class. This is part one. Okay. Stay tuned for part two. I'm gonna upload again. Okay. And that's it. Stay tuned for this video. I'm gonna start the class. Okay. This is part one, guys. Again, I'm telling you, this is part one. Just check out here, guys. Just check out here in this video. Just check out here. I'm gonna set it here as part two, okay. AutoCAD plan part two, okay. Just check out here, okay.